Hi, this is Ramshan Regalin, and this is a video a long time in the making. It's composed of two sessions, and it has to do with what it means to be a fully realized human being known as an avatar. An avatar is someone who has psychically developed to the point where they have mastery over physical matter with their mind. When it comes to this subject, people are typically most curious about the feats of mind over matter achieved by avatars. The telekinesis, the pyrokinesis, telepathy, astral travel, and all the rest. This talks about what it means to be an avatar and some of the most amazing things they're capable of doing. Many chi development practices are leveled. In other words, they have levels 1, 2, 3, and so on through level 12, for instance. The student advances gradually so the body can get used to the chakras opening and the increased flux of energy. An example of this is John Chang and Mopai Nai Kung. As an advanced student of chi development once told me that as you build your power, as you progress, what you learn and the things you're able to do become more and more impressive. He said, as you move up the levels, all things become possible. Now, in the book of Luke chapter 17, the Pharisees asked when the kingdom of God would come. And Jesus basically tells them they're missing the point, that the kingdom of God doesn't come from without. It doesn't come with passive observation. He said the kingdom of God is within you. I believe this is the meaning of the last few seconds of this video, that the fundamental difference between an avatar and a non-avatar is that an avatar is fully realized in knowing what he is, a divine consciousness within a physical body.
But if he would concentrate his investigation or examination of concept therapy, he would find that there is senses of control in the mind. It would alter the chemistry of the body. One who would take alcohol, for instance, would show no signs of alcohol in the blood by their will. On the other hand, one who would be persuaded that simple water was alcoholic beverage would show high amounts of alcohol in their blood immediately after drinking the water. Understand the difference and the complexity here, that the body, through the mind, in particular the thalamus and hypothalamus, the controlling centers for any body, and that of the pituitary and the pineal. The pituitary releases the hormones in the body that can change the shape of the body and can reproduce cells throughout the body, even to the stimulation or growth of certain parts of the body, organs, flesh, bones. This form of control or of acknowledgement or influence is seen, you'll see, in the influence of the body in regard of concept therapy as we have given. To willfully allow the body to float or levitate, this is primarily done to that of the aspects of the soul or the astral body itself. One who would be highly trained in the same can indeed make their weight lighter, but it is not applicable to lift the body or float it through the air, as it is presently seen in its dense mass, for this causes disruptions in basic physics, and of course the body does not transcend the physics, the science, and of course the influences of those influences it reside in its environment. But it may transcend the same through the mind. One who would be skilled, for instance, can cause the atoms of the body to be influenced and even disassociate or break their bond at will and reassemble at will in a different time, but in the same arrangement or as in the same mass. These would be highly skilled individuals. Avatars, you might say.
Avatar is a term used to describe a person who has attained mastery over the physical world with their mind. In sending your mind throughout human history, what would be considered the most impressive supernormal feats done by avatars? Please tell of the event, location, and time frame in which these events happened.
There are so many, it would be difficult for us to assess throughout time. The question is inappropriate in it. Demands we look throughout the history of mankind. However, if it would be for the non-avatar to understand, when one becomes in harmony with God Almighty, the universal mind, and they become part of the mind itself, while maintaining a human form. It would be like obtaining that moment of bliss, touching upon the face of God Almighty, and for a brief time maintaining that sense of complete and utter love. This type of love has no conditions. This type of love is unconditional, therefore, and once one touches upon pure love, they transform themselves from that it would be the human aspects to that it would be the divine aspects. This would be the most astounding for a human, to stand upon the threshold between the two worlds, carnal, material, gross, and that it would be eternal, divine, and all beauty. However, the question is more to that it would be, let us call them, the carnival aspects of transforming matter. Currently, the avatar Sathya Sai Baba is able to transform anything from ashes or vibhuti into the most rare medicine or any particular thing that one would wish or pray for. For all things in the world can be reduced to ash, then ash, reversing the cycle, can be transformed into anything, you'll say, in the world and beyond, you'll say. However, that is impressive would be calling back to life a human who has become deceased. This shows that the last great challenge, the last great fear, the fear of death, has been overruled or conquered by one who would be risen up to be fully aware, self-realized, fully realized as an avatar. And there have been many. Currently, this one in the East has touched upon that as to the divine and has raised from the dead within the last decade or so an individual, at least one. There are others. This would be for the carnal or small I am or finite mind, the human mind, the most astounding effect. Now, understanding that this is control over life itself and that we are selecting this for the purpose of this question does not mean that controlling the weather or any and all things that occur upon the planet cannot be done by one who would be an avatar. But let us emphasize that avatars do not work by their will. They work through divine will. And sometimes an earthquake is necessary. A hurricane is necessary. A firestorm is necessary. A tidal wave is necessary. The elements themselves must express themselves in extremes, for it is their natural state to do so. And therefore an avatar does not interfere with the natural processes or states of nature. But an avatar can speed up the process. For instance, if you were to take a seed that would ultimately be a stalk of corn with 3 or 4 ears of corn upon it, and the cycle would be 90 days, the avatar may command the seed to go through the cycle of growth in 9 days. This is what we mean by being in harmony with all aspects in this, the carnal world. We do not wish to say this is the only way, for we are not vain enough to say anything about any other mind that is divine. We only give this in reference so that the finite mind, the human mind, can grasp the meaning behind this question. For here, the finite human mind, when touching upon the infinite mind, comprehends, but not completely. No human mind, while remaining human, can comprehend the infinite. It is impossible, almost. But the finite mind can respect the infinite mind. And therein lies the curiosity, the intention, the desire, and ultimately the motivation for any human mind to seek the divine. For you see, the only difference between an avatar of greatness in history or in present, from Moses to Christ to Sai Baba, is that they know who they are, or more exactly, what they are. And humans, generally speaking, do not. Direction.